All right. Now, let me shift, Colonel, to the preparations in Davao City for the inauguration of Vice President-elect Sara Duterte. Her father, President Rodrigo Duterte, will be attending, as well as President-elect Bongbong Marcos and former President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo. Will there be added personnel deployed, that there are more high-profile and high-ranking officials attending? And this is the first time that there's going to be an inauguration in Davao City. Is this correct, Colonel?
That is correct, Sir Mike. We expect that a lot of very important people will be attending the inauguration proceeding of Vice President-elect Sara. And this is the reason why we are deploying more police personnel in that area. The PNP will be providing security together with the AFP and Philippine Coast Guard.
Mm-hmm. Are there any credible information of a possible security threat in Davao City on June 19? There have been two recent bombings in Coronadal, South Cotabato, and Tacuarong, Sultan Kudarat. So is there any cause for concern at this point?
As of today, we have not received any credible or serious threat pertaining to the inaugural of Vice President-elect Sara Duterte Carrillo. Nonetheless, the PNP and other law enforcement agencies continuously conducting intelligence monitoring and gathering. And as you have said, we have recorded a bombing incident in Region 12 and Region 9, which is approximate to the area where the inauguration of Vice President-elect Sara will be held. So this is the reason why the security will be stricter to make sure that no incident of this nature will happen.
Colonel, have the perpetrators in these two bombings been identified and caught?
The suspect, the prime suspect involved in the...
Right, we may have lost PNP spokesperson Colonel Jean Fajardo, was talking to us about preparations for the inauguration of... All right, Colonel Fajardo, can you hear
yes,
me?
Sir. Yes,
all right,
sir. Yes,
go
sir,
ahead.
Yes,
go
sir.
Ahead, ma'am. What's the update on these cases, the bombing incidents?
One of the suspects in the incident, particularly in Tacuarong, Sultan Kudarat, and Coronadal, South Cotabato, has been arrested. In fact, one of the main responsible for the incident was killed during a police operation conducted by a composite team of PNP and AFP. And this group were also the ones involved in the burning of the same bus sometime in June 2021. With respect to the incident in Region 9, particularly in Basilan, Isabela City, the suspect was already identified. And in fact, manhunt operation is ongoing, and while I cannot discuss the details of the ongoing operation, we are confident that in the coming days, the primary suspect, the persons of interest will be arrested.
And lastly, Colonel, in light of statements made that protests will be allowed in the inauguration of Vice President-elect Sara Duterte, how many police personnel are you expecting to deploy in Davao City? And what should the public keep in mind when that day comes?
Yes, sir. The mass protest is one of the possible scenario we are anticipating. That is why we are deploying more or less 3,500 to 3,700 composite teams of PNP for the inauguration of Vice President-elect Madam Sara. And our kababayans then and those people who will be going to the event are encouraged to at least make a precautionary earlier to travel earlier because border control in some areas in and out of Davao City will be stricter this time. And for those who wishes to witness the inauguration, please expect that random inspection in terms of the people coming in and out of the designated area, including their baggages and bags, will be inspected.
Are you going to deploy the same policy of allowing protests also in the inauguration of President-elect Bongbong Marcos?
Yes, sir. We will allow protests, provided it will be done in the Freedom Park in these areas. And definitely all protests, whether it's for or against, will not be permitted near the venue, sir.
All right. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, PNP spokesperson Colonel Jean Fajardo.